You've probably seen them. Silicone patches that claim to erase wrinkles, lift sagging skin, and even boost collagen production. They promise a kind of overnight miracle. Smooth skin, no needles. But is that really how silicone works? In today's episode, we explore what topical silicone actually does for aging skin and what it doesn't. We'll look at the science behind wrinkle smoothing, fibroblast activation, collagen and elastin, and separate the marketing from the truth. Silicone, what is it and where it's used? Topical silicone comes in two main forms, soft adhesive patches and gels. You'll see them sold for scars, for chest wrinkles, forehead lines, and even under eye circles. Silicone has a long history in medicine, especially in scar treatment, where its benefits are well documented. It forms a thin, flexible barrier over the skin, creating an occlusive environment. It's non-reactive, non-comedogenic, and generally well tolerated. But in the last 10 years, silicone patches have exploded into the anti-aging market. You'll find ads claiming they boost collagen, activate fibroblasts, and restore elasticity. Let's talk about what's actually true. Here's what silicone actually do, and it's not trivial. Silicone creates a moisture sealing barrier over the skin. It prevents transepidermal water loss, which means your top skin layers stay more hydrated, more elastic, and more plump. When you wear a silicone patch overnight, you're doing two things. One, you're immobilizing the skin, stopping it from folding or creasing during sleep. Two, you're increasing hydration of the stratum corneum, the outermost skin layer. As a result, the skin can look smoother and fresher the next morning. Fine lines may appear reduced temporarily. Studies show that this smoothing effect can last for an hour or two, but it does not persist once the patch is removed. It's similar to how a hydrating mask or a thick night cream might give you a glow, but it doesn't change the deeper structure of your skin. Now let's look at the boldest claim, that silicone stimulates collagen and elastin production. This would require fibroblast activation. Fibroblasts are cells in your dermis that build collagen, elastin, and the structure of your skin. But here's the issue. Topical silicone doesn't penetrate the skin. It sits on top. It's too large and too chemically inert to reach your fibroblasts or influence them directly. Here are a few in vitro studies, meaning lab studies done on isolated cells, where silicone exposure increased certain growth factors. That sounds promising, but these studies were done in controlled environments, usually involving scar fibroblasts, not healthy aging skin. And they didn't measure actual collagen being formed, just molecular signals that might be involved. Crucially, no clinical trials in humans have shown that topical silicone patches lead to new collagen synthesis, increased dermal thickness, or long-term wrinkle reduction. Part of the confusion comes from mixing up silicone and silicon. Silicone, the mineral, is sometimes taken in supplement form and has been studied for its role in bone and connective tissue health. Silicone, with an E at the end, is a synthetic polymer used topically. It doesn't nourish your skin, it doesn't deliver silicone ions, and it doesn't get absorbed or metabolized by the skin. They are entirely different. Also, in aesthetic medicine, some organosilicone compounds, like methyl silanol derivatives, are injected via mesotherapy and may stimulate collagen production. But these are not the same as silicone sheets or gels used at home. So what do skin doctors and dermatologists say? There is no strong clinical evidence that silicone used on its own boosts collagen or elastin in normal aging skin. That said, it's not useless. Silicone is an excellent hydrating barrier, safe for most skin types, helpful in preventing mechanical creases like sleep lines, often used in conjunction with other treatments like microneedling or retinoids to enhance healing. But on its own, it's a supportive ingredient, not a regenerative one. Some dermatologists describe silicone patches as a silk pillow for your face. They reduce movement and drying overnight, and that's valuable. But it's not the same as triggering collagen remodeling. What's real? Silicone hydrates the skin surface. It can smooth fine lines temporarily. It may reduce wrinkle formation by preventing nightly skin folding. It creates a safe environment for healing after procedures. What's not proven? Long-term collagen or elastin increase, not proven. Fibroblast activation in normal skin, not proven. Lasting wrinkle reversal, not proven. Structural anti-aging effects, not proven. Conclusion: silicone is a great support act in your skin routine, especially if hydration and skin comfort are your goals. But if you're looking for true anti-aging effects, stimulating collagen, reversing sun damage, rebuilding the dermis, then you need ingredients or treatments with active dermal impact: retinoids, peptides, vitamin C, microneedling, or energy-based devices. If you found this helpful, subscribe and stay tuned and avoid health misinformation. In the next episode, we'll talk about scars and why silicone in that context is not hype at all. It's real, powerful, and proven. I'm Dr. Chris Ho, a skin cancer physician in Brisbane, Australia. Thank you for listening. See you again soon.